Hello everyone, I am Naval Yemul, working as assistant professor in mechanical department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So in this video we are going to see decision making statements, so the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to create decision making statements in C++ program using different forms of if and if else statement. Content, decision making statements. Then we'll be discussing on if statement and if else statement. So first, decision making statements. So C++ allows you to make a decision based on the result of the condition. If the statement is true, it goes inside the body of true, and if the statement is false, it escapes and it goes to the next statement. So these can be called as decision making statements or conditional statements. So we'll see if statement first. The statement, if the statement is true inside the parenthesis, then it goes inside the if statement and the body is executed of the if. And if the statement is false, the statement of the if is skipped and it prints the next statement. We'll see the syntax of the if statement. So there's a, you can think what is the syntax for if statement. You can pause the video for 10 seconds and think the syntax. Okay, so we'll see the syntax for if statement. So if, then followed by the text expression and then the parenthesis bracket, and there are the statements of if statement. We'll see how the if statement works. So this is a working for the if statement. If the text expression is true, as shown in the figure A, I have taken int text equal to 5. And if test is less than 10, it executes inside the if body. And figure B shows if the text expression is false, that is int text equal to 5, and the if test is greater than 5, it skips the if body and goes to the next line, that as shown in the figure number B. So here's the flowchart of if statement. So there's a start, then followed by the expression. And if the expression is true, it goes inside the body of if statements, and then you'll get the output. Or the if expression is false, then it skips the if statements and directly comes to the stop. So we'll see a small program on if statement. So write a program to print a positive number entered by the user using if statement. So I have used code blocks to write a program. So you can write ash include iostream using namespace standard. You can practice this in your Turbo C++ also. So I have taken a variable number, and I've used cout insertion operator, enter an integer, and that integer is stored in a number. Then I have taken a condition if number is greater than 0, it shows the output as you have entered a positive integer and display the number. If the number is less than 0, or if you have entered a negative integer, it skips the if statements and come back to the second, that is this statement is always executed. Then I have returned it, returned to 0. So we'll see the output of this program. So in the first case, the user was asking to enter an integer, positive integer. I have entered 8. So you got the output, you entered a positive integer 8. This statement is always executed. Suppose if I enter a negative integer, that is minus 8, this statement is always executed. So whatever the body of if, that is your number is a positive integer, it skips and it comes to the next statement. So we'll see if else statement. The if else statement executes the code inside the body of if statement if the text expression is true, and it skips the body of else. And if you have second condition, or if the text expression is false, it goes inside the body of else statement and skips the body of if. So the syntax for if else statement. So I'll give you 10 seconds to think on what is the syntax for if else statement. So pause the video and then write a syntax for if else statement. Yes. The syntax for if else statement will be if, then a text expression, then followed by the parenthesis bracket, then else, then followed by the parenthesis bracket. If the text expression is true, it goes inside the first bracket, or the if text expression is false, it comes to the second else statement. So we'll see the working of if else statement. If the text expression is true, you can see the bracket there, it goes inside the if and it skips the else, and then you'll get the output. Figure B shows if the text expression is false, it skips the if body and then directly prints the else body, and then you'll get the output. Now we'll see the flowchart of the if else statement. So start, then followed by the expression. Here, if the statement is true, then it enters the if branch and then you'll get the output. But if the expression is false here, it skips the if statement branch and it goes to the else branch, and then your program stops and you'll get the output. So this figure shows the flowchart of if else statement. So we'll write a program to check an integer is positive or negative using if else statement. So the program is again written in the code blocks. I've written ash include iostream using namespace standard, int main, then I have taken a variable number, cout enter an integer, then I have stored that integer in number. I have two conditions here. If the number is greater than or equal to 0, then your output should be you entered a positive number, or the second condition is like else, you entered a negative integer. The user can enter both the numbers, positive or negative. So if the user enters a positive integer, it goes inside the body of if statements, or it goes to the body of else statement. But in the last, I have taken the C out. This line is always printed. So this line is always printed if the statement is true or false. We'll see the output of if else statement. So if I enter the positive integer 3, the output will be you entered a positive integer 3, and this line is always printed. In the same way, if I take a second output, that enter an integer, if I entered minus 3, you entered a negative integer minus 3, and the line is always executed. So I have taken the references from C++ Balagru Swami. Thank you.